this is Mickey from coinopnewyork.com, coinopny.com. And this is another jukebox history video. And we're going to be talking about this awesome wall box or remote selector called a Shyvers Multiphone music system. And this was made back in the 1930s by a gentleman in the Seattle, Washington area. And these units, and you're looking at one, were able to play upwards of 170 songs. And at that point in time, most jukeboxes played 10, 12, 16, or 24 selections. This is just a wall box system, but this was made it unique. So let's talk about a little history about it here. Yeah, so this was sort of interesting about Ken Shyvers, the inventor, and he made these in his garage, actually, and I guess he ended up renting out a building and making these and doing all the castings for him in the Seattle area. But we'll go ahead and look at this information. Ken Shyvers, who was credited to inventing, you know, pinball machines, or one of the inventors, also designed and built the Shyvers Multiphone music system starting in 1939. The Multiphone was a music system device that operated over telephone lines, mostly in Seattle and Tacoma and Olympia, Washington State, from 1939 to 1959. These units were typically placed on tables, counters, or bars, and a customer could deposit a coin and speak with a telephone operator standing at a turntable at a central music studio, who would then play the selection, or, you know, retrieve the record and play it. And then the music would come out the speaker at the bottom of the Multiphone. These units became popular because they had a record range of 170 selections versus jukeboxes. And at that time, jukeboxes were only playing around 16 to 24. So think about that for a second. You walk into most bars, right, or restaurants, any place that had a jukebox back then, you had maybe a Wurlitzer or Seberg. Seberg had 20 selections. Wurlitzer had 24. So you'd walk up and put a coin in and play your selection. Now, if you walked into a bar or restaurant that had one of these Shyvers Multiphone systems, you would spin this dial here, and this would spin 360 degrees, and you'd have banks of music, like Western songs, and a more Western pop music, and so on and so forth. And you would simply speak to the music operator. So you would stick your dime in, and then all of a sudden, you'd get a voice saying, "Hi, this is so-and-so. What selection would you like to hear?" And you would tell her the name of the song and the number, and then she would go get the record and retrieve it. And then magically, out of right here, your music would come out of the song you selected. And, there's no volume control or anything, but these were for individual tables. So you could see where this could make quite a bit of money, these systems. And they were all wired into the local phone lines, and they went to back to that central station. So as you can see, you know, right there, when the girl answers, "Please select the song number," by depositing a nickel. So this was really cool and innovative. And these were, some people speculate, and I believe it, that they were modeled after the Empire State Building, because they have that Art Deco tall looking feature about them. And they're just beautiful to look at, and they look beautiful all lit up. Or something really cool, the Multiphone music system, the very latest thing in 1938. And it's talking about how the girls who play the records, what they should do. So, and basically it's saying, when you put your dime in, it rings one of the girls over the leased telephone lines. And they might, if you're a regular customer, they might even recognize your voice, because you ask them, "Hey, could you play such and such a song?" And say, "Hi, Bob," when she recognizes your voice. The Multiphone inspired romance, and it wasn't unheard of for that to happen. But this was their little motto here, what they shouldn't do. Multiphone girls played records from rows of turntables as customers personally ordered up musical fare by name or by number. Studio rules posted for the girls were a few but basic. Lower the needle onto the record gently. Don't stop the turntable motor to read the titles because it tears up the gears. And don't cheapen yourself by making dates over the system. And I think that's really, really funny. They started out looking like this. This was their first model right here, as you can see. This is from the Standman site in Germany. This one had a really funky backing to it, sort of to cradle it, as you can see. And this one's an uncommon one. You don't see these very often. These are the older ones. You could see Shyvers music or music phones. And the inside. And it's just like a telephone. It's got something you listen to. Where you can hear the music coming out of, and then you've got something that you speak into, an actual diaphragm, which is located up into here. There's actually like on a receiver on your phone where you talk in right here, you know, the old style phone where you would hold it to your mouth and you'd dial the number, and then the music would come out of the speaker down here. And then these are some of the different multi-phone selectors. These were put on tables and stuff like that. And we're just sort of going through these, showing you what they look like. Here's inside of one. You could sort of see up here, and you could see right here is the part of the telephone right here that you're talking into like you did on a real telephone, as you can see. And you would deposit a nickel or a dime into the chute, and then the operator would say to you, right? And let's talk about the operators here. Let's bring this up here. Okay, here's a vintage picture of the girls talking to the customers, and you could see right up here, there's a microphone that they talk into. So when a dime was deposited into the Shyvers Multiphone wall box, it would ring one of the operators, and they would simply talk to you about the what song you would want. So they might say, hi, this is Jenny. What song selection would you like to hear? And then you would, based on going through here, picking the song you want and the number, they would go up to the shelf and pull the record, put it on the turntable, okay? And then the music would come out the wall box. And I find that very, very interesting. All right, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna convert one of these wall boxes, and we're gonna use a couple different devices to make it sort of work like it did back in the day, meaning when you stick your dime in here, you're gonna hear a voice come on and say, hey, welcome to the Shyvers Multiphone music system. What song would you like to hear? And you're gonna pick out one of your songs on here, and this dial right here spins. Because this is 360 degrees here, you know, the different song titles. So this actually spins, and there's two little washers in there that help this spin, and this is protected by plastic. And then what happens is after the, you'll hear the announcement, what song would you like to hear? You're gonna say, please play such and such a song, and it's gonna play some music. So we're gonna convert one of these, and we're gonna show you how it turns out. And stay tuned, because it's about to happen. In the game room here, and we thought we'd demonstrate and show off this Shyvers Multiphone wall box. This was, remember we talked about, this is hooked up into a phone line back in the 1930s and 40s and 50s. And there was a central location with about 15 or 20 turntables in it, and there was music, I guess you call waitresses or disc jockeys, and as soon as you put your dime in, they would say, hello, what song would you like to hear? And then you would come down here, and you would sort of scroll around and figure out what song you want to hear. Usually you'd do this before, you know, you knew what you were going to play. So on and so forth. As you can see, there's some Shake, Rattle, and Roll, Bill Haley in the comments, 17, the Fontaine Sisters, Saints Rock and Roll, Bill Haley, Western Numbers, so on and so forth, right? So you can sort of see how this happens. So We're going to play Elvis Presley, Blue Moon of Kentucky. And, you know, like I said, really these are just decorative items. And you really can't use them for much, but I figured out a way to convert it. And so we're going to put a dime in. And we're going to pretend like we're right back in the 1930s and 40s. So here we go.
Welcome to Shyvers Multiphone Music Service. What song would you like me to play?
Alexa, could you play Blue Moon of Kentucky, Elvis Presley, for me?
Blue Moon of Kentucky by Elvis Presley on Amazon Music.
Hey, okay, hey guys, we got a Facebook strike, so I'm going to re-edit this video. And so this is the spot where we tried to play Blue Moon of Kentucky. So we're going to try it again. And this time we checked out our copyrights and we've got a good song. That's all right. As you can see right down there, number 276. So let's put our dime in.
Welcome to Shyvers Multiphone Music Service. What song would you like me to play?
Alexa, could you play That's All Right, Mama, Elvis Presley?
Here's That's All Right by Elvis Presley on Amazon Music.
The great Elvis Presley, and That's All Right, Mama, one of the first songs he sang for the Sun label at the Memphis Recording Studio in Memphis, Tennessee. The great Elvis Presley singing That's All Right, Mama. All right, well, I hope you guys enjoyed it. We were able to convert this Shyvers Multiphone wall box over to sort of work like it did back in the day, meaning put the dime in. Somebody comes on, asks you what kind of music you'd like to hear, what song, you tell them, and then it plays it, just like it was back in the 1930s, 40s, and 50s, except this was hooked to a telephone line. Obviously, we can't do that, so we did the next best thing. So that's going to do it. I hope you enjoyed the history of the Shyvers Multiphone, I guess you call them jukebox company, wallbox company. And they really figured out a unique way to play a lot more music, even though it wasn't nationwide. It was mainly a West Coast, Northwest type of thing. This company took in a lot of money. It became a very innovative product. And they did something that is very, people really love the Art Deco look of these wall boxes. And instead of being just a decorative item, now it's something that can be used and enjoyed, and it's a great conversation piece. One of the things we also did was is we were able to convert these to a program, and you'll be able to make your own scrolls that go inside here and put more modern music. So that's something we worked on with a graphic designer, and hopefully, you know, in the future, we'll be able to offer those to people. So thanks for watching. This is Mickey from CoinOpNewYork.com. Hope you enjoyed this part of Jukebox History. Make sure you subscribe to my YouTube video if you're watching this on YouTube. If you're not, I hope you're enjoying this on Facebook. By the way, my YouTube channel is Vintage Coin Op. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.